Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Asan Abib. Today I lecture on bioinformatics. Bioinformatics, one of the most important topics, flow chart matrix. It's one kind of DNA substitution matrix. Today I lecture on that. I think you feel better and enjoy it. Okay, now we study it. Okay, guys, you see that BLOSUM series. BLOSUM stands for block substitution matrix. Already you know that DNA sequence or nucleotide in bioinformatics. One kind of substitution matrix is BLOSUM matrix, and it defines various kinds of BLOSUM. First of all, we see basic BLOSUM matrix. Okay, this series is created by Steb Hennikoff and George Hennikoff. Basically, this is local alignment subsequence. Okay. First of all, we should know that blocks database, which sequence it should work. You know that this works only for similar sequence. There is no gap. If you see on the screen, you see that this part has no gap. This local alignment should derived by BLOSUM. In summaries, we can say that gapless alignment blocks. BLOSUM works on gapless alignment blocks. Okay. Next slide. Okay. Here is an example that we derived BLOSUM matrix. How can we derive it? First of all, there is a sequence, DNA sequence. You see that already, you see that sequence 1, sequence 2, sequence 3, sequence 4, sequence 5, and sequence 6. And they have position. Sequence 1 have BABABA, sequence 2 position AAAC, sequence 3 position AACC, sequence 4 position AABA, sequence 5 position AACC, sequence 6 position AABC. Okay. This is our question's pattern, which is given in the question, or which sequence we should derived BLOSUM. Okay, first step is count the frequency of each amino acid. First of all, we should count the frequency. Here we see that A, B, C, three different characters. We write on it. At the top, you see that AA, this stands for amino acid. And this is defined various kinds of character A, B, C. First of all, we should count A. Here we count A. We can find 14. If we here we count B, we found 4. If we count C, here the sequence, we can found 6. Okay, guys. First of all, we count the frequency from this sequence table. Then step 2, count the frequency of each amino acid pair. You see that first here A, B, C, three different characters. We should here use combination. The combination rules NCR. Here we see that three different characters. So, we should pair, so it must be double 3C2. If we calculate 3C2, we can get 8 pair. These pairs are AA, AB, AC. Okay. Then we should go for B. Here we can see BB, BC. Then we should go C. It is only for cc. If you see that table, we can see that AA, AB, AC, BB, BC and CC. Okay. Here, step 2, we should find the frequency for each amino acid pair. We should find out each amino acid pair for each column. We can take a small example. Here is BB for 3. We should found it exactly 3 or otherwise. From this table, we should found BB is actually 3 or actually 3. Here we see that this should be column wise. Here the first column, you see that only B, here is no pair BB. Second column, there is no B. Okay, there is no pair of BB. In third column, there is BBB, 3B. Okay, so we should create column from that. This one B, you see that first B and second B, one pair, first B and third B, one pair. Okay, we found two pair, then second B and third B, one pair, we found three pair. Okay, exactly it is 3, because in fourth column there is no B. Okay, then we count CC, is it exactly 7 or anything? Okay, in this column there is no C. Okay, in second column there is no C. In third column we found that there is 2C. Here is another pair. Okay, there is a pair C and C. Okay, CC we found one pair. In fourth column there is 4 CC, C, 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 C. Okay, we should found many pairs from this column. First C and second C one pair, first C and third C one pair, first C and second C, fourth C one pair. Okay, we can found fourth pair, here one pair, here three pair. Okay, then second C and third C one pair, second C and fourth C one pair, we found sixth pair, and then last one, third C and fourth C one pair, we found exactly 7 pair. Okay guys, in the same way, you should found AA, AB, AC and BB, BC, CC from this table. After the frequency of occurrence for each pair, then we go to step 3. What is step 3? Count the observed frequency for amino acid pairs. Okay, we should find out amino acid pairs. Here is one amino acid pairs, you see that AB, from this column AB, we found this AB observed value. We should find out each pair observed value. Here is only one AB pair, AB pair object value. How can we find it? We find it AB object value is equal to, from this table, AB frequency of occurrence is equal to 8. Okay, divided by, if you summation this table, 26 plus 8 plus 10 plus 3 plus 6 plus 7. We find 60. Okay, so guys, in step 3 we found observed frequency for amino acid pairs. Here if you see that table AA, okay, AA observed value 26, total summation value 60, 26 divided by 60, 8 divided by 60, 10 divided by 60, 3 divided by 60, 6 divided by 60, 7 divided by 60. Okay, in step 3 we count the observed frequency for if of amino acid pairs observed value, then we go to the step 4. Here we count the expected frequency for if amino acid pairs. This is a crucial step, so we should concentrate it more. Okay guys, in step 4 we find out expected frequency for if amino acid pairs. Okay, here is one pair AB from this table. AB, we find out expected value. Okay, how can I find that expected value? Okay guys, see, 14/24 A. In this table, step 1 table, A frequency of occurrence is equal to 14/, if we calculation or summation this table, we can find out 24 total. So for AB pair, A's value is 14/24 multiplication. Then for B, here this table B is equal to 4 and divided by 24. Okay, already guys you see that, I think you clearly understood that why there is 14/24 multiplication 4/24. This one is for A, this one is for B, and you have confused or ambiguity for this two. Why this two? This two is stands for if a mutation occurs A to B or B to A, this will count for 2. A, if mutation occurs A from B or B from A, this will count for 2. For this mutation, here is 2. From all pairs, we should find expected frequency of for if amino acid. If we see that already we found observed frequency for each amino acid, then we find expected frequency. How should we find it? Here is the rule. We use it for each pair. For AB pairs, A is equal to 14/ total calculation is equal to 24 multiplication. For B, 4/24 multiplication 2. Okay, AB, A for A is equal to 14/24 multiplication another A, 14/24 multiplication 2. AC, for AC, A is equal to 14/24, then C for 6/24 multiplication 2. For BC, B is equal to 4/24 multiplication C is for 6/24 multiplication 2. Okay guys, we use it for each amino acid pair AA, AB, AC, BB, BC and CC. Then we find this column, expected value column. Okay, then we should go another step, that is step 5. Here we calculate the blossom value or calculate the log odd ratio. Here is the rules, 2 log 2 AB. Here is the base 2 and AB is amino acid pair. Okay guys, this is the rules. Okay, we calculate the value. First of all, we calculate log odd ratio for AB pair. Here 2 is the rule, multiplication for A. This one is observed value, AB, for AB this one is observed value and this one is expected value. Okay, we see this table, 2 into log 2, this one is mistake, here is log 2. For AB AB observed value 8 divided by 60, then multiplication 196 divided by 576. In the same way for AA, 2 log 2 26 by divided by 60 multiplication 196 by 576. For AC, it should be 2 into 10 divided by 60 multiplication 168 divided by 576. So guys, you see that when we calculate the logarithm ratio, we used this one observed value and this one expected value for each pair. For AA, 2 multiplication observed value, 2 multiplication expected value, then we get 0.70. For AB, if we 2 multiplication 8 by 60, multiplication 112 divided by 57, we got this value. Okay guys, here we see an example for Blossom matrix, Blossom substitution matrix. I think you understand it, how to derive Blossom matrix, and enjoy it. Thank you for watching this.